Is your old Mac Pro or Mac Mini capable, maybe unofficially, to run the newest macOS 12 Monterey or even macOS 13 Ventura? Let's find out. If you're interested in a different Mac model, here in the playlist you already find videos about MacBook Pro, iMac, MacBook and MacBook Air. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get a notification whenever a new video is released. But now let's start with the Mac Mini. Let's start with the actual Mac Mini from 2020, the Mac Mini Series 9, which is the first one with the Apple M1 chip. And this is obviously supported by macOS 12 Monterey and will officially support macOS 13 Ventura. The 2018 Mac Mini Series 8 is the last one with an Intel CPU, same situation, fully supported by macOS Monterey and Ventura. The Mac Mini from 2014, this Mac Mini Series 7, is officially supported by Monterey right now, but this is the first model that will be dropped when macOS 13 Ventura will hit the market in fall, because there will not be any official support for it. The Mac Mini from 2012, that is Series 6, is officially supported up until macOS 10.15 Catalina, but there is no problem at all with OpenCore to bring this Mac Mini to macOS 12 Monterey. The Mac Mini 2011, that is the Series 5, is officially only supported up until macOS 10.13 High Sierra, and there's a reason for that. The reason is that this Mac Mini has a graphic chip that is not Metal capable. Metal is a graphic UI from Apple that is required since macOS 10.14 Mojave. There is no problem to bring this Mac Mini to macOS 12 Monterey. But be aware, you need the 4GB RAM version for macOS Monterey. If you only have a 2GB RAM version, you only can go up to macOS 10.14 Mojave, and you still require the graphic acceleration patch, as Mojave is Metal required. Same situation with the Mac Mini from 2010. The 2009 Mac Mini Series 3 is a little bit difficult to distinguish. If you have at least the 2GB or 4GB RAM version, you can go officially up to El Capitan. If you have a 1GB RAM version, you only can go up to macOS 10.6 Snow Leopard. For updating, that means if you have a 4GB RAM version, you can theoretically go to macOS Monterey with a 2GB RAM version, only up to macOS Mojave, and with a 1GB RAM version, you have to stay with Snow Leopard, as this is the last OS that only requires 1GB of RAM. But there is a big but with that 2009 Mac Mini. The issues that the community reports with trying macOS Monterey on a 2009 Mac Mini are that you have very long boot times and a very slow moving overall behavior, even though you might upgrade it with an SSD. The Wi-Fi and the FireWire might not work at all depending on the installed chipset, and you may experience graphical glitches because of the very old graphics chip, especially in music production programs like Logic Pro and GarageBand. And for completion, Mac Mini Series 1 and 2, that is the Mac Mini from 2006 and 2007. If you have a 2GB RAM version, you can go up to macOS 10.7 Lion. If you have the 1GB RAM version, only up to Snow Leopard, same situation as before, but there is no update possible due to the 32-bit CPU and firmware that this Mac Mini has installed. So now let's wrap up all Mac Mini models. We start with the latest model, the Mac Pro from 2019, Series 7. Still Intel CPUs and obviously officially supported with macOS Monterey and macOS 13 Ventura. Next one is 6 years older, the Mac Pro Series 6 from 2013, still officially supported by macOS Monterey, but it will be dropped in fall when macOS 13 Ventura will be released. Now comes the series of the all aluminum Mac Pro, all the same case on the outside, nearly, but some differences in the inside. And we start with the Mac Pro Series 5 from 2010 to 2012, which officially is only supported up until macOS High Sierra, but Apple officially allows to install newer graphic cards, even PC graphic cards, in that Mac Pro to bring it up officially to macOS 10.14 Mojave. So there's no problem at all to bring it to macOS Monterey with the OpenCore bootloader. And if you still have a non-metal graphic card, you can use the post-install root patch from the legacy patcher, but be aware the graphic acceleration is still in beta development. So I strongly recommend you upgrade the graphic card in the Mac Pro to a metal capable one, and then you can use macOS Monterey without any problems. The Mac Pro Series 4 from 2009 is officially only supported up until OS X 10.11 El Capitan. Here the same, you can patch the firmware to version 5 and you can change the graphic card to a metal capable graphic card. There's no problem at all to use OpenCore and to bring this Mac Series 4 to macOS 12 Monterey. The Mac Pro Series 3 from 2008 has some more problems when you try to bring this one to macOS Monterey. Based on the community feedback, you have boot issues with the stock USB 1.1 and Bluetooth module. So you either have to remove it or you have to replace it with a newer one to avoid those boot issues. Wi-Fi and FireWire might not work at all depending on the installed chipset. So that is a problem that you find on every old Mac from around 2008. So either you can replace that module as well, or you just use a USB Wi-Fi and Bluetooth stick with a newer supported chipset. And for completion, Mac Pro Series 1 and 2 from 2006 and 7. These are officially supported only up until macOS 10.7 Lion, and there is no upgrade possible due to the 32-bit firmware, and you need a 64-bit firmware for the newer macOSs. So let's wrap up all the Mac Pro models.